Welcome back to Everybody's Golf on PlayStation 4, everybody. We're going to play Alpena Forest out on the open online course, primarily because what I want to do is try and get my fifth albatross. I've got a little notice. Ooh. So I've got some bonus screen stuff. Ah, 10 gems. Okay, I'll take my 10 gems. Ah, international tournaments. Okay. Qualifiers and finals. Oh, looks like it starts tomorrow. Okay. Well, that looks interesting. Okay. Anyway, so back to what we were going to do today. We're going to just play this as a normal round to start with, just to get, and then we're actually going to play. For real. I'm going to try and see if we can get an albatross. So, let's just check what clubs we're going to use. I might use my 164, which I'll be getting tonight. A custom club. One more. No, I remember this one. Yeah, I remember this one. And again, we're just not interested in our total score here. We're interested in getting some albatrosses, so we want to get our eye in. We want to get a feel for the course, feel for the wind, more importantly, and see what we can do. And also, we want to kind of keep an eye out for holes we think we've got a chance of the albatross on. And I think there's one coming up which people are also confident, but I'm pretty sure I could achieve the albatross.
Go for the birdie.
So let's just get started. Pick up our whole bonuses, because, you know, we like our whole bonuses.
Nice buddy. Good birdie.
And again, 11. For albatross purposes, what I'm really looking for is a par 5 rather than a par 4. I mean, driving a par 4 is just incredibly difficult. What I really want is a par 5 where I can get, you know, sort of 150 or less yards away. I give myself a good second shot into it. As you can see, you know, stopping it on a green from distance, that's only 181 away, and it just skipped on. So, and I suppose that's probably the hard part of getting the Condor, which is a hole in one on a 5, is you've got to stop it, you know, stopping it on a green with a wood. You know, it's going to need, you basically have to hit the flag and have some action on it.
Oh, well, it's a par 5.
So this is one of the candidates, because specifically you can. I mean, I don't have the length to do it, but if you've got more length, you can play for the Condor up there. What we're going to do is we're going to try here. This is just we want to kind of figure out the line and the approach. Suzuki doesn't like it. We want to kind of figure out our line and approach and how we play this. Come back and have a good go at it, try to get the albatross. So that's got 170 to go. The real question is, can I get on the next bit of green and get even closer? Okay. So. We've got the 160 power, which gives us much finer grain control of the power, which we're going to need because we overpowered that, but not by too much. You know, that's not a bad
thing.
Got it within 10 foot.
Oh, for the eagle!
I think with a couple of practices, I could have a good stab at that.
Nice eagle!
But I got my eagle.
All right, an eagle.
Oh, 13 is a par 3.
And we got our eye in a little bit, we know what we can achieve. Just gotta get on and do it.
Great shot!
Ooh, 5 hours, I'm gonna have to stop it. Oof. Oh, that was bad. That wasn't bad at all.
Oh, that birdie!
5 foot and a good shot and a birdie.
I've got yourself a birdie! Hole 14. It's a par 4.
Again, this is another kind of albatross opportunity. Just because of the position of the of the pit. But again, you know, you're driving a four, so yeah, the line wasn't right there.
Oh, that's enough!
But you can definitely get it out the back.
Ooh!
Oh, just pitched away.
Go for the birdie!
So definitely achievable.
Nice birdie!
But again, I think that's going to be harder than 12 for sure.
Hole 15! It's a par 4!
Now with a tailwind, is this... I mean, 423 is ridiculous, frankly. I don't know. Problem there is these bunkers. Is that right where you're going to land? And there's no kind of easy way out. Do you know what I might do? I might be sensible. I know, I can hear you say it. We might just see if we can power up our 3-wood a bit more.
Go! Masterful!
Oh, with the fringe. And that's going to be wet. Oh, will that hold? No, it's in the water.
I'm playable.
Well, thank you. Oh, has this got to go in then? Which it's
yeah,
not.
Good shot!
Nice shot!
Wonderful!
You got the net! Focus!
That's a tricky one for par. Actually, I need a bit more power as well. Go on.
You even hot.
That's hard work for a par.
Pretty good.
So I'll need to come back to that one as well later.
Oh, 16. It's a par 4.
This is another one you can get a water skip on. Although, actually, I think I can probably land that on the real stuff. Although it's into a headwind. I'll just give it a crack. Again, I think a bit of this is getting the right wind conditions as well.
Lucky bounce!
Skip dance, fine. It's actually gone too far, I think. Is it going to hold up? Just about.
Tidy, what's up?
That's not bad.
Amazing!
5 foot.
Oh, that buddy! I got yourself a buddy! Hole 17. It's a par 4.
Yeah, and off the long tees, this one's a bit more challenging. And we got a headwind.
Oh, good shot!
Right, clear. Go. Oh, it's the trees, which doesn't help it. That's okay. It's okay. It's in shape.
Tidy, what's up?
Again, that's a hole that's either ridiculously easy because you've got the a nice short tee and it's drivable, or when you're on the longer tees, just well, that's particularly in the headwind, it just becomes much harder.
You're on. Chance for a birdie.
But again, the green's not too bad on this one. He says missing the putt left.
Nice birdie!
Left edge.
Nice birdie! Beautiful.
So one to go.
Look at that. Hole 18.
Par 5.
It's a par 5.
Do I fancy driving it there? Well, let's give it a dig. I mean, I'm always looking to make these holes shorter.
Masterful.
Anything you can do to take the dog leg out, I think, sort of helps in distance terms. Well, particularly if you get a good skip on. Oh, it needs to stay up. Yeah. If that had stayed up, it would have been decent. It's going to be challenging from here.
Masterful.
Oh, just reached. Again, I've done this one the hard way. But again, I suppose if I'd have got a better first shot, it would have made that second shot just much easier. It's going to be short, isn't it, because of the grass?
Champion! Oh, great play!
But I got a shot at the birdie.
Oh, the birdie! A birdie!
That's okay. So 9-under for the round. We missed one of the birdies. But, you know, it's okay. So we got our iron. Let's go see if we can hit that albatross. I do find it interesting people get 1800 on that. You know, they're playing a different game
the record
than I am, for a mist. Right. Come on. Okay.
13. It's a par 3.
Ah, wrong hole. It's 14 on one. Well, that's impressive. Well, this won't make the edit, will it? Online.
Okay.
Let's walk
it's a par 4.
And then we'll quit it. There we go. Not stuck in a tree this time. So one old round. Yeah, someone's... Condor today.
Par 5.
From the flashing star. But that's not what we're going to go for. Now, I do wonder if you can skip it that far onto that bit there. Well, not from this position, clearly. Because this line's meant to go to there. But I don't know, I could try and get it up here. Have I got a chance of getting it up there?
Go! Oh, good shot!
Because again, remember, we're just trying the albatross here. The condor, you know, we'll just have to wait. Okay, so that's a bit green. It gives me 78 or 85 in. Again, it's going to be difficult out of the rough, but you've got to give it a go. So that's not you've got to be on there. My issue with the cut in the corner was that tree, but I suppose we still need to be here. Let's see if we can go up there and stop it. Clearly not. That was woeful.
Well. Hole 12. It's a par 5.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Suzuki. Well, let's try it the conventional way.
Go!
Yeah, you can't get through those trees. They're just too thick.
out of bounds.
Just too thick.
Oh, do a do.
So is there a line from sort of here?
Oh, 12. It's a par 5.
No, I think it's the answer to that. Yeah, you just lose too much speed.
Well, that's gone. I get one.
Okay, so it looks like we're going to play the conventional
oh,
route.
12. It's a par 5.
So let's try and get up here. Through the trees. And stop it on the fairway. So you got caught a bit of tree. You're for sure gonna find a route through that doesn't involve so much tree.
Oh, 12! It's a par 5.
I suppose that's the sway on the club more than anything else, isn't it? But you know,
12. It's a par 5.
I did want a bit of a challenge. Okay, got hold of it. Got hold of it. It's about just not hitting those trees. Oh, and then you got to stop. You got to not end up on that because it's just too hard from there.
Look at the gauge closely.
So I do need to back off a little bit. Okay. That won't be enough club. And it's just... yeah. Oof.
Okay. Amazing! Oh, for the eagle!
I just don't think this is going to be a good one to try it on. Let's bail on it.
Chance for a bird.
It is good. It's quite
a narrow
window of what we can do. Well, let's try it the conventional way. Let's try and see where we end up. And what that approach is like.
Oh, 12. It's a par 5.
We talked about how much you take out of this. It's how much of this corner do you cut? You know, actually hitting the shot probably helps as well.
Oh, 12. It's a par 5.
Suzuki even thinks that's not right.
I don't
know.
Lucky bones!
There's definitely 100 yards you can take out of that if you can just get up there.
Tidy, what's up?
Right, so we're 170 out. We've got a reasonable bit of wind. It's in our face.
Bravo!
Nice shot. That's overclubbed.
Eagle.
Go on.
Well, is there any consolation? That's definitely the right side of the green to end up on for that pin.
Yes! Nice eagle! It's a par 5.
I mean, I'm pretty sure if I can make that shorter, I've got a chance at it. I suppose Suzuki's happy because I've fluffed it.
Look at the gauge closely.
Yeah, you're right.
Hole 12. It's a par 5. It's a par 5.
Ooh, that's better.
Neat shot!
And this is all about where I end up. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Semi-rough. Okay, so we've got 100 to go.
It's a par 5.
Okay.
Nice!
Oh, nice shot!
Great shot!
Nice shot!
Okay, so we're a bit of fairway. Ah, oh, let me just run in. Again, we just run
in. Take your eye off the gauge!
So we do need to back off in a touch. So let's learn our lesson. Let's come off it a bit.
Watch out!
Yeah, caught a bit of tree.
Hole 12. It's a par 5.
What's wrong with that?
Don't take your eye off the gauge! Masterful!
Nice shot!
Roll with it. It's a par 4.
Ah, when our issue was we just didn't get anything close, did we?
Oh,
can we carry that?
Oh, good shot.
Suzuki thinks we can.
Don't take your eye off the gauge.
Fluffed. Too hard to do on the way back. We might change course because we're just not going to make this, are we? Oh, that's a nice little bounce. That's a nice little bounce. Now, what does that leave us?
Heidi, what's up?
60 yards, not quite the approach. Okay. So I've got my thing. So the question here.
Nice birdie!
Fireworks!